Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, I will be providing you with the daily MCQs. So the sources of these questions is The Hindu, and please try to answer all the questions. As you can see now, I will be providing daily 5 to 10 questions, and all these questions are of UPSC standard. Try to answer all, pause for a minute. And friends, again let me tell you this, these questions is to test your standards. Please don't rely only on these questions, rather these questions should be to test yourself where you are standing, fine? So it is a easy task to go through the editorials or watch any videos, but at the end of the day you have to answer all the questions in UPSC, fine? So I hope everyone have answered the 5 questions. So let's move to the discussion now. So coming to the first question, consider the following summits or organizations. See friends, recently our Prime Minister have been to Philippines. So where he attended Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Meeting, East Asia Summit plus India-ASEAN Summit. So these are the 3 summits which our Prime Minister attended. But however, there are also many summits or organizations on the same lines. So this made me to put up a question in accordance with that. So you need to know that whether India is a part of these organizations or not. So coming to the Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation, this is a forum for Pacific Rim economies, and though it involves nations from Asia, but India is not a member of this Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation. And friends, one more important point with respect to this Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation is that China is a part of this Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation, fine? And coming to the next thing, East Asia Summit. See friends, this East Asia Summit consists of ASEAN plus 8 nations. So India is a part of this summit, fine? And even India is a part of this Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So this Regional Economic Comprehensive Partnership consists of ASEAN plus 6 nations, and ASEAN plus 3, India is not a member of this ASEAN plus 3, because ASEAN plus 3 consists of the 10 nations of ASEAN plus China, Japan and South Korea, fine? And India is also member of Asia European meeting, fine? So friends, what I want you to do is to remember the nations of ASEAN. It is very easy to remember. I will give you a small trick. So it's CLMB IBPS trademarked, fine? So Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar, Vietnam, Indonesia, Brunei, Philippines, Singapore, Thailand, Malaysia, fine? So this is the easiest way to remember ASEAN. So ASEAN plus 3 consists of China, Japan and South Korea, and ASEAN plus 6, that is RCEP, consists of India, Australia, New Zealand, China, Japan, South Korea, and ASEAN plus 8 consists of ASEAN plus 6 plus US and Russia, fine? So this is the easiest way to remember this, and ASEAN plus 8 is East Asia Summit, fine? And India is not a member of Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation. So again, what I want you to do is have a detailed background of each and every particular summit, so when it was initiated and so on, which will give you a holistic picture. See, it will hardly take you 15 to 20 minutes to analyze this, fine? So the answer here is 2, 3, 5, fine? So B is the answer here. So coming to the second question, see friends, the second question is with respect to the communities. So as you could know, the Rohingya issues is in the news frequently, so this made me to frame a question in this format. So one could easily eliminate option B here. So Rohingyas are from Myanmar, and if you take Sinhalese, the Sinhalese are the Buddhist majority from Sri Lanka, and if you take Kurds, so even the Kurds are in the news frequently. They are seeking a referendum in Iraq. And friends, again, I just want you to answer in what all nations the Kurds are present, fine? So the Kurds are present in 4 to 5 nations. I just want you to write it down in the comment box, fine? And the next community is Yazidis. So these Yazidis are a Kurdish religious minority. They are indigenous to the state of Iraq, fine? So even they were in the news. If you would have come across any Kurdish article, then you could have come across this religious minority people, fine? And even they have the highest potential to be asked in UPSC prelim, fine? So this Yazidis are settled in Iraq, fine? So here the answer is 2 and 3, because the Sinhalese are from Sri Lanka, and the Kurds, again, they are from Iraq, and even the Yazidis are from Iraq, fine? And coming to the next question, again, the next question is with respect to the summits. So India is a founding member of East Asia Summit. Yes, India is a founding member of East Asia Summit. RCEP is still not in force. Yes, friends, the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership is still in the phase of negotiation. Even if you have come across today's editorial, then you would have easily observed that this RCEP is still in the negotiation phase, and India have a lack of consensus with the members of the RCEP over the issue of visa, and even with respect to the service, India has few reservations, and because of these, the RCEP is not in force still now, and it is about to be implemented by January or by December 2017. But however, there is a need for a consensus to be built in. Fine. So this RCEP is not in force. Yes, this is true. USA and Russia are the member of RCEP. See friends, I would have told you in the first slide, the RCEP are the nations, that is ASEAN plus six nations. That six nation involves Australia, New Zealand, India, China, Japan plus South Korea. So USA and Russia are not the member of RCEP. Again, if you come up to the fourth statement, then you could see that Japan and China are being members of RCEP and they are not the members of Trans-Pacific Partnership. See, again, why I involved Trans-Pacific Partnership here is because both are economic cooperation or economic agreements involving ASEAN nation. So you need to have a clear cut clarity with respect to these agreements. UPSC has the tendency to ask these sort of questions. Fine. So one should know that Japan and China are the member of RCEP, but China is not the member of Trans-Pacific Partnership. Fine. And again, I just want you to answer recently which nation came out of this Trans-Pacific Partnership. Okay. So I have asked which of the above statement is not correct. So you need to answer in accordance with that. So the first statement is right and even the second statement is right, but the third and the fourth statement is wrong. So the answer here is 3 and 4. C for cat. Fine. And coming to the next question. See friends, again, today you could have seen in the news that there was a calculation of the inflation with respect to the consumer price index. So this made me to give this question with respect to this dimension. So if you take consumer price index, then three types of consumer price index are there. That is CPI for industrial workers, CPI for agriculture laborer, and even CPI for rural laborers. Fine. And CPI combined. That is, it will consist of CPI urban plus CPI rural. Okay. So this CPI combined is released by or is compiled by CSO, and the other two, that is industrial worker, agriculture laborer, and rural laborer, are released by Labor Bureau. Yes, friends, all the above is right. So the answer here is A. So one could easily judge this because the industrial workers and laborers, so these are associated with industry, so it should have been compiled by Labor Bureau. Again, friends, I just want you to answer the Labor Bureau is in which ministry. Fine. So I just want you to answer that. Now coming to the next question, this is with respect to the Insight mission. See friends, I came across this news item on November 12th, but however, I found this question to be interesting, so I have asked this. So what happened was nearly about 1.3 lakhs Indian names were given to NASA. So they were given boarding passes. So this Insight mission is a mission which aims to place a lander on Mars. So it will study the interior of the Mars. Fine. So it is to give a broader insight about the formation of the rocky planet in the entire solar system. It will try to give that. Fine. So in particular, it will study Mars. But this news item came in because in this Insight mission, a chip was injected. That is, with the rocket, a chip was injected where the names were stored in the chips and it was sent with the rocket. Fine. So nearly about 1 lakh Indians have registered their names, and those names will be in the Mars forever. Fine. So I found this to be interesting, so I presented this with the question. Fine. So that's it for today, friends. If you have any opinion with respect to my videos, please give your opinion so that I could improve the quality of the video, which could benefit you better. Fine. So thank you, friends. Thank you for watching.